We invite you to stand and face the entrance. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We praise our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, and to be with the Holy Spirit, we wish you all peace. In the water of baptism, Margaret died with Christ and rose with him to new life. You will now share with him eternal glory. Please show me the opening psalm. Here I am, Lord. 389. 389. Thank you. homes and a time to gather, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embrace, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak,
a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busy about. He has made everything appropriate to its time, and has put the timeless into their hearts. Without plans ever discovered from beginning to end, the work which God has done, for the lot of man and of beast is one lot. The one dies as well as the other. Both have the same life breath, and man has no advantage over the beast, but all is vanity. Both go to the same place, both were made from the same dust, and to the dust they both shall return. Who knows if the life breath of children of men goes upward and the life breath of beasts goes earthward? And I saw there is nothing better for a man than to rejoice in his work, for this is his lot. Who will let him see what is to come after him? The word of the Lord.
Sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you, and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. First, especially to Denise, I am Baby and Jeannie, and families, your extended families, my friends, and loved ones of Margaret, my deepest sympathy to all of you. And my sympathy as well to Monsignor. It's always a great surprise to see extended family, clergy, and religious present. I take this as a good sign of a good life and a family life extended out generations. As the readings were proclaimed this morning, and I apologize for not having this phone system on, but we heard that concept of time. And some of the problem is in English, we only have one word for time. We have different words that might relate to it, minutes and hours and days and all those things. But in reality, there's only one time. But in Greek and Hebrew and various others, there's two different concepts of time. There's the time that is measured in hours and seconds and days and years and eons. And then there's another kind of time, an appointed time. A time when God acts, when God does something important. A time that is not measured by days or weeks. And yes, there's a similarity or similitude of all of them, that they can occur at the same time. As Margaret drew her last week, it was both a chronos time, the chronology, particular day and hour, as well as a kairos time, an appointed time, God's time. And so much of our lives, we are relatively, as Americans at least, unaware of that kairos time. And I find myself reflecting on the various things that I've heard about Margaret in these last days, and receiving wonderful stories of a life of service and of perhaps quiet suffering, maybe the word of losing her husband and losing a daughter and all those things, the quiet suffering of Alzheimer's, the quiet suffering that you as family have experienced, and saying goodbye to your mother time and again as the Alzheimer's took pieces from memory. And yet seeing the glimpses. As I say that, I'm reminded, if anyone knew the kairos time, you would have been Margaret, because you could not be late for church, apparently, even if you had speed. But that awareness that we need of God's time, that God knew in the grand scheme of things from the beginning of time, that he was going to create somebody called Margaret, that would marry me and have a family, whose family would have a family, and she would be a friend, she would be a nurse, she would be a servant to so many. She influenced so many in this community and so many in various ways. As a nurse in the O'Neill, if I remember right, and a scholar of spirit at St. Edward's, as a that point in time, hallmarks of life. And as the second reading is being proclaimed, it's been called, I think, how appropriate. Because I think if anyone, and I wish I would have gotten a chance to know when we meet Margaret in her Haiti, because she sounds like she had a deep servant's heart, that unfortunately I think sometimes it's getting more and more rare, that she would have understood how we live for oneself and no one dies for oneself. If we live, we live for the Lord, we die. We're the Lord's. And how our lives are to be spent in service. And then we will stand before the judgment seat. And Qoheleth in today's first reading, in addition to that meditation on time, telling him, I don't know if I could walk or not, I don't know anything. Qoheleth, I often joke, he could use some Prozac, because he certainly was depressed. But if we look at the context, he was about 1,000 years before Jesus Christ. 1,000 years and some time before, a couple hundred years before the prophets, the great prophets that were proclaiming that the Messiah was coming, although that was part of the prophecy long before, that there was a growing awareness of the resurrection to eternal life, and how that was to be was yet to be determined, but he lived before all of that. I think if he lived in the time of Jesus, he would have been a lot more hopeful. And so we have our excuse that we recognize that Jesus Christ is our Lord, that we live for him, because he lived and died for us to give us life, eternal life, and that he's the only way, the only means of salvation that is offered to us. And perhaps that is why the Beatitudes are so important. Because they tell us that it doesn't matter our circumstances in life. We had a reflection the other day with someone that sometimes it's easier to be faithful in poverty. It's easier to be faithful when we don't recognize, or when we recognize our little we have, because then we recognize our dependence, or our dependence upon God. And I think that's what our Lord is speaking about in today's these Beatitudes. This gospel passage that was so lovingly chosen by her family. A gospel passage that Margaret would have heard time and again. And I deeply believe in a passage she would have reflected on and lived. Being born spirit of mourning. On how many mothers she comforted as their little ones were ill. The family shared that she had a number of emergency baptisms. Those don't happen in a vacuum. And they don't happen very lightly. Margaret being there and offering the great sacrament of baptism as a nurse, as a Catholic, helping those who are mourning and suffering, those who are afraid. She was merciful. She was seeking the Lord. As we gather this day, we pray for Margaret. The most important thing we can do, we pray for her rest. We pray that God will gather her and give her peace in the kingdom. And we pray for ourselves too, that we recognize that just as she had an appointed time, that we too will have an appointed time, when we too will stand before the Lord, that we would be ready, prepared, ready with hearts that are living with Beatitudes, ready with lives that live service out, recognizing we don't live for ourselves and we don't die for ourselves, but we die for the Lord, and we die for the body of Christ, the church. I said that last night, and I'll say it again, I thank you as family, because I've heard of the devotion that you showed your mother these last years. So often, it's easy to forget those who are placed in long-term care stop in once in a while or whatever it is. And especially with those with Alzheimer's, when the responses are not so forthcoming, when there's not a sure recognition of who you are, and yet the faithfulness you've shown, the love you've shown, in caring for her and being with her, you'll be able to take that to the Lord someday. Say we loved our mother well, as she's no longer here. Your lives have changed. And what here in a little bit, I think it shows that our lives are changed, not ended. Your lives are changed, but not ended. May you experience the Lord's peace, and may you, this day perhaps, live the beatitude. Blessed are they who, for they will be comforted.
as we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Morgan, we beseech your mercy that she, who did not doubt herself to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful heart, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always in our prayer, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection is drawn, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. So with angels and archangels, with thrones and minions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glories without end, we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, in prayer, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Salvation. Be pleased to confer in faith and charity your helper of church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope and Chad, our bishop. The order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
Remember your servant Margaret, whom you called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when he fills the earth, he will raise up the flesh of those who have died, and transform our holy body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, to whom all are pleasing to you at their passing through this life, be kind of commitment to your people. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you are God as you are. We shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through the living and heaven, O God, mighty Father, in your name, the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Step back.
Exit, if you step back to the left of us, who may wish to come forward, that is one may or come forward and has their one hand to my point. With your arms crossed, and we will pray for the prayer of spiritual communion instead. For those with mobility issues, we will, one of us will go to the back after we are, after we see or distributed our reading on the wall.
Thank you.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, come for the journey. Mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our sister Margaret may come to the eternal people of Christ. For this reigns forever and ever. Special word of thank you to our musicians and the choir and Mary Kate. Claim I understand Mary Kate and Margaret worked together in 4-H for many years, and thank God for her, Mary Kate's ability to play this morning. To the grandchildren, providers, and great grandchildren servers, and of course, Monsignor for assisting this morning. This time we will have a commendation along with the song of farewell, which is on page 33. Not to go to the cemetery, please feel free to go downstairs. I know we have plenty of food, and I think we have plenty of seats for everyone. Go downstairs and have a seat, and lunch will be served as soon as the family has returned from the graveside service.
Peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.